Greetings, family. Welcome back to my channel. It's your friendly man in the street, Jamal Curry. Just making a short video, I would like to discuss the situation unfolding in the Bahamas in regards to the deportation of illegal immigrants. All right, as you all remember, recently we had a terrible storm, Category 5, with over 200 mile per hour winds. And as a result, many of our people were displaced from their homes and had to be dispersed throughout the islands and in Providence and the southern islands of the Bahamas. But basically, what has taken place, immediately after this took place, the country began to do everything it could to ensure the welfare and well-being of those who were affected by the storm. All right? But after this period took place, similarly, the same thing took place after the earthquake. All of the deportation was ceased in consideration of the well-being of the people who were affected. Basically, what took place, most recently, our government has resumed deportation exercises, which it is constitutionally mandated to do. All right. Now, the thing is, the United Nations recently issued a pronouncement asking for our country to basically halt the deportation of immigrants, right? And it is basically given the impression that it is inhumane and inconsiderate, right? But if you consider it, the United Nations is basically telling our lawfully elected government to cease and desist what it is lawfully mandated to do by our people, by our constitution. All right, now I am one of those people who is pro-Africa, pro-African descendant, but in our country, we have a unique paradigm in that we have a very fragile sovereignty and resources issue, which needs to be addressed by the effective management of our land, our resources, our space, and the controlling of those who would enter our borders. Now, as you can all consider, having porous borders is not beneficial for any country, because the fact is that means anything can enter your country. A nuclear warhead, toxic chemicals, fugitives, international criminals. We need to be able to control our borders to prevent the creation of a situation in our country that is not beneficial. All right, so I would just like to close with these few comments. The fact is, the United Nations cannot pose as the moral authority of the world if, in fact, they were basically accused and found guilty of raping young children and women in Haiti during their peacekeeping mission. So the United Nations has in its roster people who are raping citizens in third world countries. So I don't believe that they possess the moral authority to criticize our country. And so in closing, it's very hot in my location for this video. So people, let me know your thoughts in the comments below about all of these dynamics. My heart goes out to those who were affected by the storm, and I hope that the international community can have some consideration for our plight. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. One love.